These show the quantitative criteria under the IMF program, the primary balance wage bill, and net international reserve, net domestic assets, and a net change in the stock of arrears, the continuous performance criteria, and the indicative targets. This will continue to be the basis until it is changed for the fourth review and Article 4 consultation, which I spoke about. The real sector, particularly oil and gas, is set to perform well going forward. The specter of doomsaw is something which is being brought under control to the point where as we speak, the projection is that supply could exceed demand, which will be reversing the situation in about 2 to 3 years' time in terms of power supply. And we have had occasion to stop the processing of independent power producer applications until a comprehensive review that is being done, is completed. The World Bank documentation that supports the World Bank partial risk guarantee have also all been completed. And as I said earlier, we are on course to have the third FPSO, which will increase the supply of crude as well as gas. Gas is expected to flow from the TEN field from the beginning of next year. And therefore, we are likely to see a more stable supply of gas to augment the sporadic supply that comes from Nigeria. And this is why we are confident that doomsaw could be put behind us and we could go back to the early days of the Akosombo Dam, when power supply is stable. So there are bases, for the assertions that we make with respect to the oil and gas, sector, with benefits that will come also from midstream and downstream, where hopefully a lot of business opportunity will come, whether with respect to bitumen, fertilizer, breakthrough, and other such production as is envisaged. Our development partners have been supporting the budget, and we want to acknowledge that fact as well, except, as I said, some of it is delayed. We embarked on significant revenue administration reforms. The Ghana Revenue Authority was created to replace the Revenue Agency's governing board. That was earlier than the 4 years, in 2009. But growing out of this, between 2011 and 2013, we brought together the VAT service and the Internal Revenue Service to form the GRA Domestic Tax Service. We also started together with GRA to divide the tax offices into large taxpayer offices, medium taxpayer offices, and small taxpayer offices in order that we can target services to these categories of taxpayers, particularly the small taxpayers in the informal sector of the economy. GRA is employing ICT. There's the TRIPS, which is the system being put in place to manage domestic taxes. We all know about the single window, so I don't have to repeat it, which is the integrated single window for customs and other trade-related processes, which we know is performing remarkably. We also have the Geographic Information System, GIS, employed, and the GCNet, which is a custom software. The goal is to integrate all of this, just as we are doing on the expenditure side with the GIFMIS, which is an integrated system. So we integrate the revenue systems and the expenditure systems. And then as we'll see, we are paying attention to debt or financing. So the debt management system will be integrated with the GIFMIS. And everything will be on electronic platform. The payroll is electronic, pay slips electronic, vouchers, what we call the pay voucher, which is validation of the payroll, is also electronic. And government is moving to implement a e-payment system through, as we saw with the Visa, Ecobank Visa card for the payment of customs transactions. Even the purchase of fuel will move electronic. You know, using, you know, cars, travel will move electronic. And public servants will not be required or will not have the need to collect, to carry large sums of, you know, foreign currency, which they have to declare at every checkpoint as they go into, you know, their travel. So the electronic payment system is something which will add to that. We have revamped all, the emphasis is on all, our tax laws. We now have the GRA Act, which I mentioned, the VAT Act, which replaced the 1998 Act, the Income Tax Act, new one that replaced the 2000 Act. We have a Customs Act, which you won't believe, replaced the 1985 Act. And we have in the process of passing regulations to support all of this. This is desirable, but the unfortunate thing is many of these rationalization of the tax laws were often taken as an imposition of new taxes, when in actual fact, they were only meant to improve the administration of the tax regime, as we all desire, and we are all fond of saying, we must expand the tax base. We cannot do that without a kick loss. To give an example, the services sector, you cannot manage the services in the services sector with the 2000 Income Tax Act. And certainly not if you are going to manage VAT, which has customs or import and export elements, you cannot do so, you know, with the 1985 Act, because customs collects, for example, the import VAT. And therefore it's important that we brought this, you know, legislation, you know, up to date. These have been achieved, and the country can boast of a menu of tax laws that have been put in place. We now turn to expenditures, and we'll be coming to the closer to the end of the presentation. We have implemented a lot of measures with respect to expenditure and debt management. And let me just run through, you know, some of them. Sorry, I think I've jumped. As with the tax laws, we have replaced the Financial Administration Act, and elements of the Financial Administration Regulations and the Loans Act, which was a 1970 Act, with a uniform, with a comprehensive Public Financial Management Act. Apart from the consolidation, it also includes for the first time budget responsibility provisions. You'll recall that this was to be passed as a separate law. So it has come together with clarity in processes. For example, it gives better clarity to the sinking fund, which we are using to manage the debt, and adds more provisions to it. It has also compliance and sanctions provisions, and the regulations would, and work has started on the regulations and will be sent to the next parliament. The gift mix, which I mentioned, has a financial accounting model, it has a budget model, and a cash management model. And these models have interfaces with the payroll and with the human resource management system, which has been missing for a very long time, spearheaded by the Public Services Commission, a contract database. The GRA system will also interface, because the fiscal starts with revenue. And then procurement, public procurement will move electronic and interface with the GIFMI system, you know, so that the controls will be there and remove the human discretion. And above all, our debt management system at the Ministry of Finance will also interface. In that case, it will be integrated, you know, with the GIFMI system. And this, we expect, will enhance expenditure, you know, controls. We have introduced some budget measures, such as putting a moratorium on new contracts and making sure that every contract has a budget provision. We have not achieved that yet fully, but we've set a foundation to make sure that, and this will be reinforced in the budget responsibility, you know, provisions of the PFM Act. And it even makes it an offense, you know, to spend beyond your budget. This is one way of controlling, you know, minimizing things like the election year expenditures that we will talk about. We are aligning the statutory funds to national objectives and winning off some agencies that can stand on their own. And then we have improved the dialogue with respect to wages, placing it within budget constraints, and negotiating the wage bill before or as part of the budget process. Therefore, as we speak, this is the second year in a row in which we are not negotiating wages now in anticipation of the budgets to be read maybe sometime in late February or March. This is the second year in a row, and you would all agree with me, it has brought some stability, not just to government, but to the private sector because of the minimum wage and the clarity that it brings, because the budget then comes with the compensation package, which used to be, you know, unknown. One of the phenomena which we have tried very much to improve is the Ministry of Finance gets a lot of technical assistance on revenue and tax administration. The Ministry of Finance gets a lot of technical assistance on expenditure. But besides the Commonwealth and a small team in the World Bank, there was virtually no assistance on financing and debt management. Little wonder that one of the problems we have had as a country is debt management. But after all, the deficit which must be financed is the difference between revenue and expenditure.